Well, thank you very much. What a group this is. Ooh. And we want to thank the fire marshals because they had a lot of work to do to get this crowd. We got a lot of people outside, thousands, and this is really great. We're very, very honored to be here in Manchester, a place that I've gotten to know very well on the political trail and love, and in particular to be in the great state of New Hampshire. As I promised you, and as you know from the beginning, I fought to protect and defend New Hampshire's beloved first in the nation primary, and you got it. You got it. And next year, we're going to make history together when we win New Hampshire primary for the third straight time. We've had a lot of success here. Today, I'm deeply honored to receive the endorsements of more than 50 New Hampshire state legislators, many of whom are on stage with us and some of whom are in the audience because I think structurally, maybe the stage couldn't take it. But I just want to introduce them, if I could, quickly. They're great people. They went out there right from the beginning, most of them have been with us right from the beginning, and we love them, and they're just special people. Represent to a finish. Is that okay? So I do that early so you can think. Otherwise, if I do it right at the end, that's the better way to do it. I'll finish, and then I say, any questions? Okay, let's get out of here. Now you have a whole little time to think about it, but we'll take a few questions, okay? You think Biden takes questions? I don't think so. I don't think so. You saw yesterday, he had the cue card. He said, call this one. This is what she's going to ask, and here's the answer. They never did that with me in the White House, I can tell you. On Tuesday, Joe Biden officially announced that he will seek four more disastrous years in the White House. As you know, I've done very well against crooked Hillary Clinton. But today, I'm going to do this, and I think this could be maybe the most important part of what I'm going to say, because this is going to be a major announcement. Are you ready? Is everybody ready? I will be retiring the name Crooked from Hillary Clinton and her moniker, and I'm going to give her a new name. I don't know, like maybe Lovely Hillary or Beautiful Hillary, but I'm going to retire the name Crooked, so that we can use the name for Joe Biden, because he'll be known from now on as Crooked Joe Biden. You would think that Hillary would be very happy today. She's out there someplace celebrating. Because there's never been anyone in the history of American politics so crooked or dishonest as Joe Biden. And the press absolutely refuses to report it, all that press back there. Because, frankly, they're just as crooked as he is, and they are. They're just as crooked. The choice in this election is now between strength and weakness, between success or failure, between safety or anarchy, between peace or conflict, and prosperity or catastrophe. We are living in a catastrophe. With your vote on November 5th, 2024, we're going to crush Joe Biden and the White House, that gorgeous, beautiful White House. We have to take it back. We're going to beat him at the ballot box, and we're going to settle our unfinished business. But now we will do it again. We will do it again. We passed the largest tax cuts and reforms in American history. We cut more job-killing regulations than any administration ever, also in history. We achieved American energy independence, and we were about set to do American energy dominance, bigger than Saudi Arabia, bigger than Russia combined, times two. And we slashed the price of gasoline down all the way down to $1.87 a gallon. Doesn't that sound good? That's why you have this horrible inflation, because of what happened to your energy. Now everything's up. Now it's happening to everything. Thank you. Thanks to our policies, the typical New Hampshire family saw their annual income rise by $6,000, the largest increase in recorded history, the largest. Nobody's ever seen that, by $6,000. Everybody was happy. For decades, the corrupt globalist establishment savagely betrayed New Hampshire workers. You know that better than most. I see those beautiful factory buildings. Some are now apartment houses, and some are now senior citizens. But the factories, that's what you had to do. The factories, there's so many gone. Your state lost 1 in 4 manufacturing jobs after the NAFTA disaster and China's entrance into the World Trade Organization. But after years of cruel sellouts by past leaders, I ended NAFTA, the worst trade deal ever made. That was the worst trade deal ever made, what they did to us for so many decades, and replaced it with the incredible USMCA, Mexico-Canada. That's considered now the best trade deal ever made. So good, in fact, that Mexico and Canada are now trying to renegotiate the deal with the Biden administration. I say, don't do it. Don't talk about it. Don't do it. Somebody over there told me it's unfair. I said, you know what? We lived with unfair for decades. Now they say it's unfair. No, we made a great deal, and you're all manufacturers, farmers, everybody is benefiting. USMCA, we're very proud of that. Don't let them renegotiate. I withdrew from the job-crushing Trans-Pacific Partnership. That would have totally destroyed this country. They were all set to sign. Obama, Barack Hussein Obama, they were all set to sign it. And I stood up to China like no administration has ever done before. Bringing in hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars pouring into our treasury from China when no other president had gotten even 10 cents. Not one president got, and I literally mean not 10 cents. We got hundreds of billions of dollars. I don't think they like me too much, but that's okay. Well, everybody else is paid off by China, including, by the way, our president, okay? It's a big problem. You wonder why he does nothing about China, why he doesn't do what he's supposed to be doing, because he got millions of dollars from China. You see it. I made big promises to the people of New Hampshire, and as your president, I kept every single promise. When China unfairly targeted our lobstermen, I gave them hundreds of millions of dollars in relief straight from the money we were taking in from China. We took a little bit out, like a little bit's hundreds of millions of dollars, by the way, but that's a lot to a lobsterman. And we brought it back. I made a deal with the European Union to completely eliminate tariffs on American lobster. You know that. They were charging us big tariffs so that we couldn't sell to them. The first EU tariff reduction on any product in over 20 years. Nobody ever asked the EU, or if they did, they didn't get it. because they're very difficult people to deal with. I want to tell you that. They don't care about us. They care about them. And maybe that's the way it's supposed to be, right? I also opened up 5,000 square miles of ocean that Barack Obama closed to New England fishermen. You know about that. But you also know I opened them up totally. Nobody could even tell me why they closed. Think of miles and miles of beautiful oceanfront. And now I understand that they want to close it up again. Is that true? I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Yeah, let Canada do all. You know, Canada's the one that wanted it closed because they want to do the business. And I gave our farmers $28 billion out of the tariffs that we took in from China because they were treated very unfairly. I said, how much would it be? They said, approximately $28 billion. I said, I'm going to take it from China. China paid them $28 billion. Who else is going to do that one, okay? Tell that one to President Xi. You mind giving our farmers $28 billion? Actually, better than that, we signed an incredible trade deal with China. But once COVID came in, I didn't care about trade deals so much. But it's a tremendous trade deal, $50 billion. And it was an amazing deal. But once COVID came in, I didn't even talk about it. In everything I did, I put New Hampshire first and I put America first, everything. When I left office, we handed Joe Biden the fastest economic recovery ever recorded. All with no inflation. We didn't have inflation. We had low energy prices that kept it down. When he stopped the energy, stopped the drilling, you know, I have a sign, drill we must, right? They have a sign, don't drill. We won't, just, they won't do it. They won't do it. What they're doing is crazy. And what it's done is raised everything. And now everything's so high, and now they've taken on their own inflationary trend. It's not just energy anymore. But they did that with energy. They destroyed our economy with the high prices. All electric cars. Oh, that's wonderful. Everybody. They don't have enough electric to turn on the lights. And now they're going to say, let's do all electric. I love electric cars. They go for about an hour and a half. Then you're in the middle of nowhere. You're saying, how do I get this thing charged up? He took that booming economy and he promptly blew it to shreds. He took the greatest economy in history. It was just announced that in the first quarter of 2023, GDP growth was a very weak 1.1%, and the forecast show it's going to be getting much, much worse. So we're at 1% and getting worse. That doesn't sound too prosperous, does it? Look at these other countries that are eating our lunch. I had them. They were doing anything they could. They respected your leader. They respected your country, I want to tell you. They saw me coming. They weren't happy. They weren't happy. Every time France or one of the countries, but France in particular, they were a little difficult. I really like their leader, but he's a very difficult guy. And whenever he got cute and wanted to tax our people or our companies, I just say, that's okay. We're going to put a 100% tariff on all wine and champagne coming into the United States. They would say, no, we will not do it. We have decided we won't do it. No, but I don't think they do that. I don't think they do that in this group here. We should have tremendous power. We have tremendous economic power that we don't use. But, you know, we better be smart because soon we're not going to have economic power. We're not going to have anything. Since Joe Biden took office, the typical family has lost over $7,400 in annual income. Think of that. Inflation is out of control. Banks are collapsing. Banks are going bad. That's a bad sign. You remember 1929, it started with the banks. Real wages are down 24 months in a row, the longest losing streak ever in our country. Think of that. Real wages. That's what it's all about, is real wages. The trade deficit has surged to a record $1 trillion. Household wealth has declined by $4 trillion. These are numbers that nobody's ever seen before. You know, they stand up and they say, no, the economy is good. The economy is horrible. After Biden shut down the Keystone XL pipeline that I started and passed a $20 billion tax hike on American energy, gas prices in New Hampshire are up 53%. And your state, congratulations, you did have one good thing from this administration. You set a record, if you like records, but not like this. Your state has the highest electricity costs in the entire nation. Tell your governor he ought to work on that a little bit. You know that, Steve? You have the highest cost in the entire nation. I will quickly be able to cut that number in half or more than that. I'll do that. Nobody knew that. New Hampshire has the highest electricity cost, I think the highest energy cost, but highest electricity cost in the nation. Let's go to all electric cars. How does that sound, right? You have the highest electric cost in the nation. They don't want to give you, they don't want you driving. You're like, how about driving for about an hour and 15 minutes? And then say, it's time to get a, time to get a charge. Joe Biden cares only about enriching his own family. I care about enriching your family and you. A Biden victory will be bad for you, good for China, and truly great for these globalists. We got a lot of globalists. A Trump victory will be bad for the globalists, the rhinos, the communists, the Marxists, but it will be great for the hardworking people of New Hampshire. Within hours of my inauguration, I will begin the process of terminating every Biden policy that is brutalizing New Hampshire and all U.S. workers. I will restore my famously successful executive order requiring that for every one new regulation, two old regulations must be eliminated. That was so successful. You remember that, when I did that? And I was actually getting 12, 13, 14 cut down. It was amazing, actually. But they put many of them back. But they haven't been able to up your taxes yet because we have a very strong bill. We went through everything to make sure that nobody could tamper with it. But they're trying. They're trying to raise your taxes very greatly. Instead of growing the size and scope of the federal government every year, we will shrink it every year with aggressive cost reduction targets for each federal department. But we'll take care of our military. We have to. We have no choice. A lot of bad actors out there looking to do harm. We will take care of our military. You know, I rebuilt our entire military. They gave $85 billion of it to Afghanistan, but in probably the most embarrassing moment in the history of our country, $85 billion worth of brand new military equipment. I will create a true national trade policy like the kind that made New Hampshire a manufacturing and industrial powerhouse in the old days. Remember the old days? You see those buildings all over and you say, wow. I did a great job in renegotiating trade deals with other countries. They were the worst, the most horrible deals I've ever seen. I'd often wonder to myself, who the hell negotiated these deals? They were so bad, they were either like very, very stupid people or they hated our country. Could only be one of two. I think both. Yeah, I think probably. I think maybe both. No, the worst deals I've ever seen with Japan and with South Korea, Mexico, Canada, China, all of these countries, it was amazing that how bad they were. And, you know, like South Korea, we take care of their economy, we take care of everything, we take care of the military. They're right next door to Kim Jong-un. He and I have a very good relationship. People would say, it's not good to have a good relationship. Yeah, it's very good to have a good relationship. It really is. But he's not so happy with Biden. He says bad things about Biden. But what I really wanted to do, the Trump Reciprocal Trade Act, you know what that is? That will go along with the Trump tax cuts, which they haven't been able to terminate because we've drawn them so powerfully under the Reciprocal Trade Act. This is, think of this, every country. Do we have any children here? No. Couple. Close. That's such a good-looking guy. Put your hands over your ears. Every country, he'll hear it soon enough. Every country is screwing us, right? So they've all charged us taxes and trade barriers. India, China, everyone. Europe, by the way, all over Europe. Under the Trump Reciprocal Trade Act, if India, as an example, or China, Europe, any place, any country charges us, let's say, 100% or 200%. That's what they do. You could ask Harley Davidson. You could ask a lot of companies that are unable to put their product into these countries because what they do, they make it impossible. We immediately charge them the exact same thing. It's called reciprocal. So if India charges our companies 100, we charge their companies 100. It's very simple. And yet we have people in Congress that say, no, I don't think that's good. Anybody that says that's no good. Very interesting. Lindsey Graham, the progressive from South Carolina. No, he's a progressive. Signed a law prohibiting child sexual mutilation in all 50 states. And this is what we must do to save our country from destruction. 2024 is the final battle. If we don't take it over, we're not going to have a country anymore. I want to be positive. I'm just telling you, we're not going to, if we allow them to cheat, because it's the only way they're going to win the election. If we allow them to cheat again, you're not going to have a country. If you put me back in the White House, the reign of corrupt Washington establishment will be over, and America will be a free nation once again. With your support in this election, we are going to complete the mission. We are going to finish what we started. We did so much. We rebuilt our military so much. But we have things to finish. Stand with me, and together we will defeat the globalists, the Marxists, communists, and the rhinos. And we will also defeat the fake news media, because they're in on the act. We will evict Joe Biden from the White House. And we will restore the American Republic as the strongest, freest, and most powerful nation the world has ever known. We're going to get ourselves back there, and we're going to get it fast. They know me very well. They're not looking forward to having this happen, but they'll live with it. Actually, we got along with them pretty well. There were certain assets also. You know, other countries need a strong America, not just us. Other countries need a strong America. The USA is a mess. Our economy is crashing. Inflation is out of control. Our banks are failing. Russia has joined with China. Saudi Arabia has joined with Iran. China, Russia, Iran, North Korea have formed together as a menacing and destructive coalition. Our currency is collapsing, and the dollar will soon no longer be the world standard. Can you believe this? And that will be our greatest defeat in over 200 years if we lose the dollar. There's a really good chance that we will. But it won't happen with me, not even a small chance. Just like Russia would never have invaded Ukraine, like China would not have even thought about raiding Taiwan. Wouldn't have happened. They understood. They understood. Can't do that. I used to say that if you took the five worst presidents in the history of the United States and added them up, they would not have done near the destruction to our country as Joe Biden and the Biden administration have done. But now I say, if you took the 10 worst presidents, because I really believe that, if you took the 10 worst presidents and added them up, they would not have done to our nation what this man and what this administration has done. And by the way, they're going to, after this speech, they're going to be coming after me big time. We are a failing nation. We are a nation in decline, and that's what's happening. I hate to say it. It makes you sick to say it. And now these radical left lunatics want to interfere with our elections by using law enforcement. And we can't let that happen. With all of this being said, and with a very, very dark cloud hanging over our country, I have no doubt that we will together win the presidential election of 2024 and make America great again. We're going to do it. Thank you. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. God bless you. And now God bless me, because I'm going to take a couple of questions, okay? Where are we going to go with the questions? Do we have a mic at some point? Do we have a little mic? Oh, go ahead, please. Yes, yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Gerard. Thank you for the shout out earlier. Sure. I appreciate that. One of the issues we are super passionate about at the New Hampshire Federation of Republican Women is women's sports and keeping biological men out of women's sports and out of women's bathrooms.
Right.
We recently released a statement calling out Chris Pappas and Ann Custer for voting against the Protection of Women's and Girls Sports Act. So how do we ensure that women can compete on an even playing field and feel safe when it comes to this issue?
Vote for Trump. That's how you do it. Okay? You're going to have no problems. You got me on that one before it was even an issue. It's the craziest thing. And, you know, it's amazing. It's such a good statement and or question, but so many people, they hear it, they can't even believe it. They can't even believe what's going on with that subject. No, no, you vote for Trump. That's going to be totally gone. Okay? Go ahead, please. Yes, go ahead.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. Thank you very much, Frank Dawson, and thank you for the phone call 3 years ago.
I remember that, yeah.
Thank you very much. You are the man.
Thank you very much.
I would like to ask you a question concerning the military. Okay. Do you promise the veterans out there, guarantee them that you will make our military stronger as it was before you were pushed out of office, and you will return, and also make a promise to all law enforcement, all legitimate law enforcement, that you will protect and support them all the way?
So I remember the call. I don't know why, but I have a good memory. But I remember the call very much. I appreciate the love with that statement, not just a statement. The answer is yes. We rebuilt our military. We have the finest equipment in the world. You know, we had jets that were 48 years old, where the grandfather was flying them. Some of the bombers, the grandfather was flying them, and now the grandson is flying them. Now, we're redoing our military. We redid a lot. As you remember, I made Space Force, and they tried to end it as soon as they came into office, and they had a revolt in the military. We created Space Force. That's the first time in 78 years since the Air Force that something like that's been done, creating a new branch. So the answer is yes, 100%. You will be satisfied. Not only that, the veterans are very satisfied, 92%. But now, in other words, we had an approval rating, the VA, of 92%. That's never happened before. That's a real job. You know, we got approved where you can fire sadists and sick people. You know, you couldn't fire them. No matter what they did, you couldn't fire them because of lots of reasons. I won't blame civil service. I won't blame unions. I won't blame anyone. You couldn't fire them. And we got that done. And we also got it done where you can go out and get your own doctor, and we pay, because some of the veterans, as you know, were online for weeks and months. Some of them became terminally ill, waiting to get just a very simple procedure or prescription. They'd have to wait 4, 5, 6, 7 weeks. And we made it, you understand this, those two things were very important. The ability, we fired, I think, 12,000 people. They were sadists. They wouldn't attack these people in prime time, I can tell you. But they were sadists, they were thieves, they had some very bad people. We got rid of them. We actually had that passed in the legislature. They've been trying to do it for 48 years. And then on the other, as you know, that was a big deal. If you have to wait online for any more than 24 hours, you have the right to go out and get a doctor, get yourself taken care of, and we pay the bill. And that worked out unbelievably well. You know that's true. That's why they liked us. But the answer is yes, we'll take care of it, okay? Thank you. Good to see you. Okay, please.
Good afternoon, Mr. President. I'm Christine Peters, also from the New Hampshire Federation of Republican Women.
Good.
And two of the top three issues that women are concerned about right now are inflation and the economy. And how do things like the environmental social governance play into all of the economic issues that are facing women?
Well, they do. And, you know, you have these fanatics, the environmental fanatics. I'm an environmentalist. A lot of you are, you know, you want clean water. We want clean air. Nobody wants dirty air and water and other things. So, but you have to be reasonable. These people are crazy. They're putting windmills all over the place. They're going all over windmills. The birds are, you want to see a bird cemetery? Go under a windmill sometime. And they're made in China, just so you know, and causing a lot of problems, very expensive. But I will say this, we will take care of this inflation by going and drilling. You know the sign in Con Ed, they have Con Edison in New York, utility. They used to have a sign, dig we must, drill we must. We must drill. And we did some job. We had it down to below $1.87 for a period of time, gasoline. And what a difference that made. When they came in and they closed everything down, they got rid of Anwar. Anwar, since Ronald Reagan, they've been trying. Ronald Reagan couldn't do it. Bush couldn't do it. Nobody could do it. I got it done. The biggest site probably in the world, drilling in Alaska, they ended it the first day of the Biden administration. I mean, you think about it. They ended it the first day of the Biden administration, a site that would have been almost the size of Saudi Arabia, maybe bigger. And they ended it. But we'll do it again. We can do it again. We'll get it done again. When you reduce the price of energy, everything else is going to come down. And when everything else comes down, what we'll be able to do is get the interest rates down, and we're going to get our country back. Because our country, the way it's going right now, is going into a depression. We're going into a depression, like a 1929-type depression. And we're not going to let that happen. But we're going to drill. We're going to get energy down, everything else. When they held it back, the energy became so oppressive, so expensive, that everything went up and you had inflation at a level that you hadn't seen in 52 years. And it's still horrible. But we're going to bring energy down, way down. We're going to get the interest rates down. We're going to get back to a great life. We're going to strengthen up our military. And we're going to be able to deal with China and Russia and everybody. And they're not going to play with us. They're not going to play with us. Thank you. Okay. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yes. Go ahead.
Is it on? Okay. God bless you, President Trump.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
My name's Christine. I'm from Atkinson, New Hampshire. And engaging with young voters is crucial. Here in New Hampshire, we have American First warriors like Caroline Leavitt. How do you plan to engage with Gen Z voters?
Well, I think we're doing that. And I tell you what, you would be shocked, like Charlie Kirk and others, the job that they do with their youth. It's a youth movement. It really is. That's another movement. You would be shocked to see how popular we are on college campuses. Much different than what you read, much different than what you hear. But, you know, one of the things about having this horrible thing take place where we've lived in 4 years of hell in this country in many ways, in many, many ways, more ways than you even know. But one of the things is they have shown how bad they are. And we'll be able to do things now to get it straight. Now, we have to make our city safe again. We have to clean up our areas. We have to get things going in this country again. They've shown how bad things are. The voting is so dishonest. People see it. People see it. All you have to do is just have a little common sense, and you see the level of dishonesty. Because we want strong borders. We want great elections. We want strong elections. We want great education. And all of the things that have happened in the last 4 years have shown how bad these policies are. And it's actually, in a certain way, going to make it much easier for us. Okay, one or two more. Go ahead. Do you have anybody over there?
Mr. President, what happened
to that man with the mic? Let's go over here.
Hi, my name's Tony. I'm actually here from the Cape, all the way from Cape Cod.
Nice place.
Very nice. I just have a question on election integrity. So we're all here for...
Or lack of integrity.
Thank you. That was going to be my next question.
How are we going
to take back 2020? I know we've got 2024, but we need to still work on what happened with 2020. And how are we going to make America great again by taking back the 2020 debacle?
The best thing we can do right now, and there are a lot of people going, you know, working very hard on 2020, because, you know, history, you can't forget history. If you forget, you're doomed to failure in the future. But there are many cases going on right now. You know that. I think you're involved in some of them. But there are many cases going on right now in different states. If you look at Wisconsin, what they found out in Wisconsin, they were one crazy vote away from turning over the election. And they should have turned it over. This was a political whack job that voted the wrong way. And other judges on that panel just excoriated him. But you look at what's happened in some of these states, they get it. They know what happened. But you know what we have to do? Never forget that. I'm not one of these, sir, you have to forget it. So many people say, sir, put it in the background. You can't forget. Because if you forget, they're going to do it again. What we have to do is we have to win. Because, you know, you're talking about a very short period of time. We have to win, and we have to win big. We have to win. We have to really swamp them. You know, if you swamp them, there's not a thing they can do. There's a level at which they can't do it. And to be honest, we did so well last time, I sort of thought we swapped them, but they used COVID to cheat, among other things. So they used COVID to cheat. We're not going to let that happen, and we're not going to hopefully have any of that. But we have to watch. The most important thing you can do is on election night, meaning election period, I'm sorry to say. You know, France just had an election recently, 36 million votes, all paper ballot. You had voter ID, and it was same day. So you had same day, voter ID, all paper ballot. The election was over at 10 o'clock. The numbers were cast. Everybody went home. Congratulations. There were tears and there was joy, you know? And that's what we should do. Same day voting. Because when you have voting that lasts for 44 days and everybody's looking around and moving things around and where are the, well, why is this truck here? What are those things that are moving in and moving out? People have to have confidence in elections. People have to have confidence. The problem is we have a lot of people without courage. That includes judges. We have judges that looked and they said, oh, boy, I'm not turning this over. They didn't have courage. They didn't have courage to do what should have been done. But we can never forget that. And it is a lot of